Behind me, you see some of the olive trees that will produce the olive oil that goes ultimately into Dr. Bronner's organic and fair trade soaps. In 2005, we embarked on a program that has as a goal to convert by 2007 more than 95% of our raw materials to sources that are both organic and fair trade certified. As part of our visit, we have organized inspections by an independent international certifier. We're here to meet with the farmers, to look at their operations, to make sure that farmers are paid a fair price for their products, to make sure that the entire value chain meets organic standards. And that's something that does require some personal presence. So far during our visits, we have been very pleased with the level of integrity that we've been observing, and the initial observations by our certifiers confirm that this project, in fact, is an important step to convert significant numbers of olive farmers to organic farming while making sure that they receive the benefits of fair trade.
Fair trade olive oil is produced according to production guidelines that pays attention to the social aspects of the economic activity of producing and doing a trade. We look at aspects of wages for workers, aspects of what is the farmer getting. Fair trade, it's a social concept where people are organizing cooperatives, work collectively. Second, fair trade ensures that all people involved are getting their fair share out of the production. Palestine is recognized as the natural home of the olive tree. And these olive trees are still the same ancient olive trees that has been grown in Palestine for over 1,000 years. And they produce an olive oil that is really a cut above what's out there in the market from other Mediterranean countries.
Most of the olive oil produced by Arab farmers is organic by its nature because nobody uses pesticides and the other chemical materials. Indiana is a fair trade project working to market products from the Arab community in Israel. The founder of this project were women, Arab and Jewish women, who believe in a common future for the two people in this area. I think people in the United States should understand that it is not enough to say, okay, I'm for the peace, I want people live together, love together. It is not enough. We have to change the basic situation in our region. We have to give the opportunity to live in dignity and to have enough income to feed his children and give them good education. Without these basic necessities, we cannot speak about peace. And I think what Dr. Bronner does is showing that a solution for the Middle East starts from a real economic opportunities. Peace cannot prevail without economic solutions.
Olives in the Middle East are being planted in land where you couldn't have arable crops. The idea of Dr. Bronner's mixing oil in order to produce a product, and the oil is coming from different sectors of the people who live in Israel and in the West Bank is a great idea. I'm actually the perfect example. I was fighting, or let's say I was engaged in the confrontation between the Arab or the Muslim part of the Holy Land and the Jewish part. And I can tell you honestly, we have come to the conclusion. We did come to the conclusion that unless we find a way not only to mix the oils but to mix our lives, there is no future for neither of us.
I think blending olive oil from Palestine and Israel is a symbolic but significant contribution to promoting the concept of coexistence and cooperation in this area. We feel that supporting these farmers is particularly important also because it is quite obvious that the lack of a decent living for many people in the West Bank is one of the causes of the vicious cycle of violence and counter-violence in the area. And we're not naive in thinking that by purchasing some 100 tons of oil per year from this area will solve all the economic problems. But from our visit here and the discussions with our partners, we feel very strongly that we can make a little bit of a difference in this area and help create critical mass and also set an example for farmers to find value-added markets for their products in the West, which is what we believe is very crucial to support sustainable agriculture in the West Bank and ultimately make a little contribution to empowerment and the move towards coexistence between Palestine and Israel. It is very important to bring to the attention of the consumer the fact that they can make a difference by purchasing raw materials or products that are produced both in an environmentally and socially sustainable way. And we believe that beyond our own sphere of economic influence, we can trigger interest among other companies to do the same and basically look at their supply chain in a holistic way.